Well, we're gonna do a test real quick on our fire stuff. So go ahead.
Yes, what Ranger Cookie has right there happens to be Mountain Man's ferro rod that I bought from him, and believe me, it works. So, we all know that pine straw is flammable, and to save for the sake of grace, what we're testing here is a technique that I happen to see on YouTube. Straight up and down, pull away, one strike, and it's lit. Yes, the idea is behind this. When you take your knife and you're sitting here and you're trying to hold your knife steady, there's a chance that when you pull away your ferro rod, your knife wants to go into the tinder and blow it away. But Mr. 80's podcast channel, if I've got that correct, suggested that you put your ferro rod directly above it and then brace your hand with a knife in it. You were putting it out for a purpose. That once you brace your hand either on a rock or a limb, anything wood, we're going to use this example, your knife is now braced, and when you pull your ferro rod away, the sparks go directly down into the tinder. And guess what, ladies and gentlemen? We know with a cotton ball it works. It seems like it works all the time. We've done this test, what, two, three times already?
Yeah.
Let's do this again. We got pine straw. Okay, it shouldn't catch up, right? It should not catch up. And let's just see. We're using this as the tinder.
So we're
And
going to do something else, or we're going to do the
let's do
same?
the same thing. Let's use this right here. We're going to improvise. Brace your hand in any way you want to on that. Of course, that's not very, very steady. All right. And he's going to simply go straight up from and pull away. And you're still at an angle. See how bad it is to break that habit?
Oh, so he wants it
The
straight up?
ferro rod has to be straight up.
Oh,
There we go.
I thought I did that a while
You
ago.
did that. There we go. It seems to work. Now, we're going to try this again. Put you out. Put you out right quick. One more little cotton ball. Now we're going to try it the way that we've always been taught.
Oh, there.
See how, well, it did light, but see how the knife wants to go into the tinder and knock it out of the way? But we're talking with a professional here who's actually executing this particular thing, and it works very, very well if you know what you're doing. So, that being out of the way, we're going to get into the actual fire test. What is flammable and what is not? What's the first thing on the menu today?
What can you use with a pack of matches, a lighter, a magnifying glass, or in the fire steed rod? So let's find out. Let's start off with no. There you go. Polyester.
Polyester, is it flammable?
I'm gonna try. I'll just go ahead and do the fire sheet. If this can light that, anything else can light it except for the magnifying glass. Okay, let's see.
I saw the spark. Sparking. It's sparking all around it. Wow.
It's burning right through it.
But it's not actually catching.
Oh,
Ah, there it goes. Oh.
So polyester. Hang on, let's see if I can do it.
It wants to. It's like a burning fuse.
Well, you
Okay.
will die. You will die on the polyester.
Grab the lighter.
All
Let's see
right.
how it lights up with an actual lighter.
We can find a lighter that runs. Actually run. And looks like I don't have a lighter that has any fuel in any of them. Here you go. I would die out here.
Oh, there we go. Well, ladies and gentlemen, polyester,
Does not work.
it's burning here. If you can see it on camera, it's actually burning through, but it is a more of a melter.
So this is a fail. So throw it into the fail side.
Ow! It stuck to my finger!
Basically. All right, I heard that the tater chip can burn, but what's the difference from lighting it with the fire seed rod versus the lighter.
You miss. There it hit, direct hit.
All right.
But I'm actually thinking, hold on, I'm actually thinking, if my hands aren't too wet.
Yeah, we didn't crumble it up.
But my fingers are probably full of moisture. It's so hot and humid out here. But that's part of the realism. We need a fire. And all we've got is a tater chip.
A tater chip? We're going down. We're going to starve.
Ignore all the pine straw. Pretend it's not here. It is showering everywhere.
Nope. No can do. Let's see if I find a working lighter.
Lighter.
I think you're supposed to hold it over.
Yes, I think you're right. The oil from the corn chip works very well.
Well, we got a fire, but
you know what? He's got some old tater chips. They're probably like 10 years old.
So we could say maybe a fail, or maybe we.
I would say that this is plausible.
Maybe. Plausible.
Possible. Possible. But in this case, fail.
Hey, let's put it in this hole.
Oh yeah, let's dig that hole.
All right.
We're trying to be cleanly.
Remember, all right.
Leave no trace. Styrofoam.
Styrofoam.
Oh, very good attempt.
All right, let's get some, you know how styrofoam is. Let's get some pieces.
Are your hands as wet as mine?
No, dry. I'm seeing got holes going in them.
Wow, pull back for just a second. Can y'all see that? Look at all them specks in there. I hope you can see that on camera.
All right.
Nope, this way. A bit more.
It shows all.
Okay. There we go.
All right, we'll see.
Oh, he's got the wide angle on there.
All right, lighter.
Lighter. I was going to say something else. She's lit.
All right.
Okay.
The striker versus the lighter. The lighter wins. On this is a good one, but you got to use the lighter. So
it works best on lighter.
Or the matches, so that's the same thing. We never try the magnifying glass because we don't have sun.
Wait, there's some sun. There's some sun. It just popped out. But is it enough?
Well, yeah, I could start a fire with that because that's, well, it's very sooty. Bad for the environment. But hey, I can start a fire with this.
If
I find
a star.
Yeah.
A star. Yes, we're trying to get a star. We're trying to get a fire started. I'm trying to say.
Bad for the environment, but good for you to survive.
Right.
So we're going to throw that in the middle because it's a negative because it's.
A negative with a ferrocerium rod.
Yeah.
But a very positive with an actual lighter.
All right, next test.
You know what? I'm not picking that up.
No. No. Who wants to pick that up? All right. We know that these fire starters start with what? Only the lighter, correct?
Pretty much a lighter, and it has to be, well, let's find out.
Let's find out. Let's see.
We'll put it out and save it.
Let's see if fire steed rod can light this. You'll probably have to crumble it up. It's like dog food.
Let's see a piece. I'm trying not to get it too wet because my hands are sweaty. We're going to start this with a lighter first.
I was going to break it up.
Yes, but I'm going to try it whole. Because I've seen this done before. Actually, where you break it, the fibers are exposed. I hope this is picking up. Yes. Oh, we got some motor.
I know, definitely. The fire seed rod is not going to work on this.
Now,
item.
However, I have heard that you got to rough it up. Once it's rough, we need something under there to catch it. Let's see. You got any aluminum in there?
Aluminum. Oh.
Aluminum. I did not bring in aluminum.
How about a piece of paper?
Okay, we'll try it with that. If the paper catches on, folks, that doesn't count. I just want to rough it up.
So you're roughing the stick up, or you're trying
roughing
to put
the stick up, but I'm actually catching what's underneath it as well.
So that might work with the fire seed.
Well, let's put some on the paper just to be on the safe side. But we're supposed to rough this up, and I'm trying not to get my fingers in it because they're completely soaked. Now, ferrocereums. The ferro cereal. Looks to me like we're crap out of luck.
All right, let me try the ashes at the bottom. Not ashes, but...
And we're going to test the paper at the same time.
You want to lighten it?
Yes, wax crepe paper.
All right, that's a fail for the rod. So let's see what happens if you light it with a lighter.
What is this stuff again?
This is the stuff you buy at the Walmart.
Up, there we go. A little bit of a flame. Oop, there it is.
Well, the fire seed rod didn't write the crumbs from this, but hey, it lights with a lighter. Well, that's a good thing for a lighter, so we go to put...
That is definitely a plausibility. Yes for the lighter, no for the ferro rod. Now look, if you happen to get this thing going with a ferro rod, then you've done a lot better than we have.
Yeah. All right, next test. Let's see what we got.
Remember, what we're testing here is something that works right every single time when you need it.
Okay, you know these little plants?
Oh, yes. You know what? Let me give you a little bit of advice I found out.
I found these, this go poof, and they're done.
Yes, they go poof. Do not compress these or try to light these when they're compressed. They have to be fluffy.
Yeah,
remember.
Fluffy. Keep it fluffy.
Always fluffy. Not even going to try that with a lighter because I know it works well.
Yeah.
Stand clear.
Yeah.
There we go. Poof. There it is.
But can you start a fire with that within a reasonable time?
You can as long as you have something like this on top.
Okay.
Grab some more.
What? More?
See, grab a little bit more because that won't catch on fire. I don't think it will. Just a itty bit. Let's put this right here. Say if you have some pine straw. You know how difficult pine straw is?
Yep.
And it doesn't want to catch that spark unless it's processed. I'm going to put a little bit on top.
Yes.
Where are you going to shoot it at?
I'm going to shoot it right there in that little hole.
There,
right,
that'll
there.
Be a good test right there.
All right.
Now. And you got to manipulate it a little bit. Oh, I was too late. Here we go. Try number two. Hot dog. There we go.
I'll tell you one thing. It just flames up and it just goes out.
You know what? That's surprising.
Yeah,
I would have bet my paycheck
no,
on that.
No, you
will. It will work.
It
will work.
It work, but you.
There
you go.
Go.
All right.
So that's a good one, but you got to pay attention.
So if you can light with the spare seed rod, it's definitely going to light with a lighter. So we're going to put that on the yes. We got two yes.
100% yes.
We got one half and one a no for
okay,
both.
Okay, I'm playing fire department.
Fire department.
Do not try this at home.
Yeah.
All right, we're scooping this to the side, keeping a fresh pit. We do not want any excuses.
Yeah.
We say, oh, you had embers in the bed, and no wonder it lit.
All right. Egg crate.
Ah, yes.
Now, let's see.
Hand me one little chunk. While you're doing that, I'm going to try this. I'm going to rough one up for him.
Yeah, that's what I was hoping I was doing.
I'm going to get the fibers exposed. You need it. Stop.
You want to take a break?
Yeah. The bird.
I hope you enjoy our
video.
It's
not going to blow up, is it?
Well, I hope you enjoy our video of making fire with different items that you find. I hope you enjoy our videos because that's a mess from hell. All right, I'm Ranger Cookie and this is
Manland
saying goodbye, Mama Larry. All right, this is called the torch. Let's see if it works. What you want to do is stick it in the ground. This is from an old paintbrush. The paintbrush thing came off, so you fill it with cotton, then pour alcohol in it. This is good to cook food on if you have. There, bitch.
There we go.
Now I got me a lantern. I'm gonna see if I can. I don't know if I can cook on that. It's a small flame.
Well, I didn't put much alcohol in there. Now I wonder if it goes all the way down on the handle.
No, I think it stops here.
Okay, blow that out. Well, is it out?
Yeah.
We'll add some more to it. We'll see if we can't get a big old flame going. Yep. It went down in the hole too. Now.
Maybe I'll make a wick going all the way down. Yep, it's on. I wonder if I can cook anything with that.
You know, I just realized we put the wrong fuel in there. To make a torch where you can see by 70% or 90%, rubbing alcohol would work better. Because it puts out a very bright yellow flame. This is almost burning clear. Which is perfect for cooking.
I'm curious. That means I have to hold this thing to either cook or boil water.
Yes, and then your hand gets a cramp.
Yeah, so it was a good idea if you want to start maybe a fire.
But I'm thinking that actually if you needed a little torch to see by, some type of, ooh, it's hot.
Yeah, so that theory went out the wall and it's still lit. That's cool. And it's still lit like a lantern. Not recommend to touch. So maybe I could start a fire with this, you know, place it halfway into my fire and it's still lit, and add to my Kindle like a flamethrower. A hot one, that is. Shush. I got an idea.
We have a severe grippy problem.
I have an idea.
Is it still hot on the handle though?
And it's
still burning.
Still lit.
Set that on fire. Still, I like that idea. I can see some distinct possibilities with that.
Only thing you have to do is make sure you got some gloves with you. Man, I gotta light the whole woods on fire with this thing. It's a little miniature torch.
Not a bad idea.
This was an old paintbrush and it just fell apart. Maybe you go to Walmart and you find one. I've been looking for one. It's stainless steel. So, hey, I just want to show you this cool little torch thing. Let's find out what's next in the arsenal. Q-tips. Can you light Q-tips with a fire ski ride? Let's fluff it up. Let's move some trash. All right, basically it's a cotton on a stick. And it's lit. Now I can place this anywhere, just like my torch. It's like a match.
That is neato.
And probably later on it burned the plastic and you start a fire. All right, this is a good for everything. Lighter, matches, that's a good spot. All right, Landman says chapstick.
Chappy of the sticks.
Maybe we need to chop our sticks.
Yeah.
All right, how the hell would you use this?
What I would do is a test, and very quickly.
Rub it on something?
No, let's just pull it out the end of the tube and light the end of the wax itself, which in theory is probably just gonna melt and not burn.
Yes.
It has to be on something combustible that acts like a wick.
How about we just take a little paper? No, not paper, because there we go. This will be a little harder to light. I'm just going to rub some chapstick on a piece of paper, like a stick, maybe. If I was in the woods, I would rub it on a stick. If that lights, we definitely know we can light it with other material. All right, lighter.
Yeah.
It just melt like wax.
It melts like wax?
Yep.
And
no light.
It will light. depends on what kind of chapstick you got.
Well, I maybe got the crappy chapstick.
Try something. I'm not going to give up on that one. Trying to do this for the camera to see.
Yeah, you can see.
Oh, ferro rod. Oh, that's the paper burning. But it's a fire extender.
Yeah, it's lighting up pretty bad. I mean, pretty good. With,
And the idea is to, the wax keeps it burning longer. And it appears.
So, what you think on this one? Halfway or all
I think it works, but in this case, because we did it on camera, it didn't. We'll come back to it.
All right. Maybe out in the woods, or maybe around a environment where they got trash.
No, I know what happened. Santa Claus finally had an accident. And he crashed. He fell out of the air. And now we have Christmas paper laying everywhere.
I know it's going to light with the cigarette lighter, so... Let's see if I fluff it up. Come on, work, you bastard. I'm starving out here. Alright, since we're there, might as well grab the wax paper. It's like butcher's paper, kind of, looks like. Let's see if that light up. Oh, well, first strike.
Oh! Do it again, get it out. Do it again.
Where's that thing, round thing?
Where's the thingy? I think that was a fluke.
Alright, let's try it again.
This wax crepe paper actually lit.
And quick.
I'll be dead gum. Look at that.
All right.
That is reliable.
Christmas paper, flaw. Wax paper for whatever this paper is.
What do you call that? Gift paper? Yeah. Wrap that, like, you stuff gifts
yeah,
with?
Yeah, basically. Yeah. It has a smell to it, unless it's the Christmas paper.
But I mean, it's thin tissue paper that lights up very quickly.
All right, we'll see you out in the woods. You brought you some biscotti.
Biscotti.
We'll see what happens if we...
And in this case, because we're from the south, this is Bubba Sketty.
I don't think this is going to light it. Let's find out. All right, let's try the lighter.
Buscetti does burn. Unlike stale potato chips.
Now, multiple use. I can cook with it. And I can start my fire with.
You mean you can eat it? You can cook with it.
Oh yeah, you can cook with it.
And start a fire. And eat it.
Well, fine.
Hey, triple function right there.
Alright, we got the last few tests. We know this is not going to work. Hey, what happens if you had a sponge with you? You cleaning your pots.
Cool.
Well, but I guess once you use it to clean your pots, I don't think it's going to be useful for anything. Just go tear a little piece, fluff it up. All right, let's try the lighter. No conveyor, but I bet you. Now we're going to try some injector cleaner.
Okay, give me a moment. Let me get out of the way.
We're going to use this as a cotton ball. So I guess using this as a sponge for your liquids, probably ideal. I could probably stuff it in my little stove I have around here. The little thing I should.
But it's going to burn away. I think it's just going to melt and burn away.
Well, that's good. That's what you want. To start a fire.
You want it to go away. But you definitely don't want to use this as a...
Sponge.
Sponge. Anticipating it's going to hold your fuel inside the stove and not burn away.
All right. Last few tests we got.
You've done this before, haven't you?
With this? All right, we'll see you out there in your blue jeans and you need a fire. Even though most people just say I'll cut some wood down. You don't mind, sir?
Ouch, I cut my blue jeans.
People use this for char cloth. So what happens if I need to light a piece of my jeans? Oh, the paper started.
Hey, that's the paper. Hey, that's the paper that wouldn't light a while ago.
No, it was filled with...
There it goes.
And it lit. Now, if it lights with this, you know it's going to light with a lighter.
Absolutely. I knew that was going to work anyway. Because... I don't know if I can get my leg in there without getting bent. Let's see. This is a wet blue jean. This will not work. But if it were dry, then you would take your knife and gently rub it, start to bear down, and you sit there and you scrape some nap off of your blue jeans. And that's all I'm going to do. What will you end up with?
A little lint.
It's a little cotton ball type of lint on the end of it. I don't know if you can see that or not, but yeah. Anyway, we'll rotate it. And we know that that's extremely flammable.
All right, our last few tests. We already tried the fuel injector. It works, but I don't know if it'd be good for cooking. It might be a chemical thing, but lighting fires, putting in your balls of cotton or something be a good idea, and put your balls of cottons in some type of container. All right.
So in other words, it'd be good at lubricating your cotton balls. Thank you. Ooh.
All right.
Baby scent fresh.
Last two tests that we got. Then we're going to go through. This is steel wool at its finest.
Uh-oh.
Yeah.
You've heard that one too. Wow. That was a given.
So, if you can light it with this fire seed rod, you can light it with a lighter. If you can light it with a lighter, something that you might not know, that you can use a battery to do the same trick. Alright.
Yeah, there's your cotton ball right there. Now,
there, you want to make a little fireball?
Let's make this. Now, this is something that I've been dwelling on in my head for quite some time. If you happen to have your cotton ball, and you happen to have your steel wool, and all you have is that so-called battery, can you make a flame out of this combination? Zapper. And
I guess the battery's halfway dead.
Wow, what kind of battery is that?
All right, let's try the fire seed rod. It's automatically hit the cotton ball.
I know, let's try to hit.
Well, this is the test with the battery. It's supposed to be a test with the battery. And it's not doing squat.
There it goes.
It must be at the ends. That's what it is. Breathe down. There you go.
Oh, I got it. So, even with a weak battery.
So, combination of battery, cotton ball, and steel wool, you will have a fire.
Now, that's good to know.
That is good to know. Two picks. No, Mama, don't destroy our film. All right, our last two tests, two picks. I'm going to rough it up a little bit. And these are not toothpicks, these are like shish kebab things. Alright, that didn't work. This is like starting a normal fire with sticks, so I guess we could just say whatever with this one. Now, the last ingredients that Mr. Landman didn't think about. It's my secret ingredients. I want to show you how I'll make one of these. But first, I have to get...
Here's a stick. Kind of a stick.
Yes.
Well, it's kind of a wimpy stick.
How about a toothpick?
Oh, a toothpick works even better.
So, we're going to get some of this out. Let's see if this will work. I don't know if this is going to be... Y'all ready for this one? This is supposed to be gunpowder. All right, didn't work with the fire seed, Rob. Let's see if it worked. I noticed gunpowder only lasts a few seconds, then it's out. So you better have your... There you go. Here you go, Bear Man.
Hey, hey, hey! What is that?
It's a like a firework.
Dude, that will definitely start a fire. Burn, baby.
All right, we got electrical tape. Let's see if this light up. Yep.
Stopped it too soon. They always say it's one of the best fire starters there is, but guess what, ladies and gentlemen? I mean, this fire extender here, you know what? That's BS.
Yep, that is BS. This electrical tape, it starts the fire, but...
But it doesn't actually burn. It more melts than anything. Check that out. Hi. Like I said, that's one of those instances I would have bet my paycheck on. Assuming that you can see it's not lighting.
Damn. Well, electrical tape is out the box. It's a no-go.
That is actually surprising and disappointing.
All right. What else I got? I got athletic tape. Let's see how that works.
Athletic foot tape.
Hey, this is good to take with you because you never know when you need an emergency situation. You can tape something, bind something.
Yes, but start a fire.
Start a fire.
Or as a fire extinguisher.
Now, I noticed this is made out of cotton, so we're going to have
hopefully a better result.
Let's see if I see like little threads and string. Let's see if I can. There we go.
You want to, let's do the first test for the lighter and see first.
Hang on, that thing's sticking to me.
Grab your lighter in there. There, yeah.
All right, okay, we got to go on this one.
Now, I'd like to try
the fire seal.
The fire seal, I want to put the sticky side down. Or is it the sticky side that may catch on fire first?
I don't know. Let's find out.
All right, let's find out. Tongs, insert tongs. Just look to the tongues.
Don't want to go up. Dang, that's a good fire.
That is so much better than that dadgum electrical tape.
Yeah, so, all right, let's try the fire steed rod. I'm going to do it one upside down and one tape down. This is the tape down, and this is the tape up.
So,
He don't want to let me go. Let me go, Mama.
Where's the stick? There's a stick right now. There's on the stick. All right. All right. Tape up, tape down.
Let's see. And let's do the... Damn, that thing's hot over there. Let's do, like, what's his name? What's his name?
80s Pod Channel. Straight up. But I'm telling y'all what I notice. The fire is going straight down, but it's still going everywhere but the target area.
I see sparks all over that.
It's all over, and she's just not doing it.
Well, fire cease ride failed, but the matches, lighters will work, so that's going to be...
That's a good...
Good
lighter,
to have.
A lighter deal. That's a lighter deal.
I can use this multiple use on this one, which is good to have in your bag. This is a bond. Let's say you broke your leg, blah, blah, blah. Bam. You got multiple use. This is a good item to have. Bam. Over here. All right. We're going to have... All right. Duct tape. What's the difference from duct tape and electrical tape?
I don't know.
Well, let's find out.
You know, okay, since I was wrong on the electrical tape, I'm going to take a wild guess.
It's not going to work either.
I'm actually thinking that is because that has some type of fibers in there that reinforce that tape. And I think those fibers are going to be what actually lights up.
Let's find out, ladies and gentlemen. Here's the end. All right, shall I make one face up, one down for the fire seat?
Let's try it with the lighter first and see if
we can see. Wait. We're not going to cook my ass.
You're going to be smart about this, aren't you?
Okay,
what,
lighter.
You don't trust me?
Oh, I trust you. I just don't.
It melted quick.
I don't want to get burned. That's why.
All right, aha! We're melting and burning.
That's like a milk jug.
So the fibers actually act as a wick, whereas the electrical tape has no wick in it. Interesting.
All right, let's try the fire steed ride. So would it be face up, face down, or both?
Oh yeah,
I don't think the fire steed ride, because it's a flat surface. There's no fluffy to it unless you cut it all in pieces. I already know this is going to be a fail, but this is a test, so what the hell. Let's try. Yeah, I don't think it's going to light because it's flat. You need a lighter. So that's going to be the middle, I guess.
You got a better chance of lighting up your girlfriend.
All right. You women know what this is. I got two types. This is like a brick. This is the white sanding block. This is also good to sharpen your knives with. Multiple use. Again.
Really? You can sharpen your knife with it?
Yep. It's a little sandy. I mean, if I do it right.
I did not know that. Hey, that's neat. And it's good at fingernails, too.
So, I know it's going to light with the lighter. That definitely is going to light with the lighter. But we'll find out if it lights with the fire stay dry. Nope, I'm putting holes in it again.
Now, what if you were to rough up a section?
That's a good idea.
Oh, I thought it almost did.
All right, let's try it again one more time.
That's gonna work.
But I know definitely the lighter is gonna burn this bitch.
I think it's just gonna milk it. It's burning!
But that'd be easy to put
it's
out.
It's an itty bitty fire.
Yeah.
It had an itty bitty flame. It's alright to be itty bitty.
Well, you've seen that one. Alright, let's do the y'all know, women also know what this is. This is the opposite, another thing. These are little sponges to put makeup on. Ooh, I got makeup on! And I just wet the...
You just wet it.
Just wet it.
Hey, man, nurse sponge.
All right, I'm going to fluff it up. And see, this lights. Now, this does not have a multiple use. I bet you if I soak anything in alcohol, is going to light up. All right.
Lighters on. Is the material itself flammable?
It's a fail.
It appears not to be.
This is the little stuff that women put their... This was only a dollar, so you can give it to your wife.
Okay. She doesn't use it anyway.
I have no use for it no more. All right, what else we got over here?
Look, he's got a bag of weed. We're not going to light that up. We're going to utilize it later.
Now, folks, y'all seen everything on how to light stuff, but what's wrong with a sparkler? You can't use a fire seed rod on this, so we're...
Now, that right there, in my opinion, has to be a very good deal. And let's find out if it's waterproof.
Now, I've seen everybody light fires with all kinds of stuff, but not a... What is this bad thing?
That's that bad thing right there. Let's see if it still burns underwater. Oh! Ooh, that's the El Cheapo version. It went out.
Yeah.
But it will start a fire.
Definitely. It will kill you.
Fire extinguisher. Hey, look. Sparkler tea.
That was one of my hidden things that people don't think about is a sparkler. Bring you one. I bet you light a fire with no problem. But you got to bring a lighter.
And I didn't even know that because I forgot. You know what else would light a fire?
What's that?
What it'll blow it up? An M80.
Yeah. Well, blow it up and start a fire.
Yes.
All right. We all know about lint. Lint in your dryer is free.
That's belly button lint.
Or, hey, you got dingleberries. You can dig for those, too, if you run out. So if you need a fire, you can always get some dingleberries. And also, it depends on what fiber this is. This looks like blue jays. If it lights with the fire seeds, go light with the lighter, so we can just rule that one out.
But there is something I'd like to say in advance of that. Remember, that is dryer lint. You also have polyester and a lot of other stuff in there mixed in with it that may not burn so well.
For a sample, here's the bag. That looks like cotton. Blue jeans, some hairs from humans, and whatever. It looks like a sock.
And probably a cat got in the dryer.
He never did. Ah!
Larry! That's what happened to you!
Yeah. No,
that's
Larry.
Why he's not here.
Alright. What else we got? The cotton ball swabs.
Oh, very interesting test because they're flat.
All right, they looks like they're already fluffed up already. Damn.
They do. Uh-oh.
Let's try this one.
Yeah,
lit.
It's lit.
Damn, takes in its time too.
It sure is. It's so compact, but it does a very good job.
Very good job. So that's a good one.
Of course, we know about petroleum jelly. We just want to see what happens with the ferrocerium rod as is. What, pray tell, is that?
All right, we got two items in here. This is plant food that you buy for your plant. And I'm going to just see what happens if I put this in a jar. I'm going to go in camp and I put this in a jar or something. And I'm going to see if I can light it. And I got a straw. I know for a fact. Oh, shit. We got embers over here.
Amber. No wonder we're smoking. I thought it was the rice over here.
But you make a little hole right there and put some water in it.
I'll tell you what. Let's dig a little bit.
All right. Plant food. Let's see if I can, rough it up maybe. All right, a little rough up. Plant food. I think I'll light the mud first. Nope, no good. Let's see if the lighter will work. Yeah, hate to hold it in my hand. It might be a big firecracker. Blow my freaking hand off. All right, looks like plant food is a no-go. All right, straw. We know what's going to happen with the straw. That sucker's going to light like a freaking firecracker. I don't need all the straw. But let's see about the... I'm going to use the paper wrapper. See if to light the paper wrapper. And light the straw. Nope. All right. We know the lighter's going to work. Voila. And voila.
Remember what I told you about leave no trace?
What trace? There's nothing here. All right, now we're going to try the
eggshell.
Yeah, eggshell.
Carton thingy. Been fluffed up with a knife. Ooh. Ooh. Sparks went all the way around. Yeah.
See, going straight up, it's the same thing as knocking your shit around.
Ah, it did.
But you probably got a chance to, you would survive if you had the right ideas and right stuff to do it.
But ladies and gentlemen, to be honest, we did not make enough fuzz. You need more of the fuzz on there.
So we got we got potential.
We got embers. You just need to fuzz it up a lot more.
Yeah, it's about it. But
preparation's the key. And out here, we're fighting time. Rain's on the way. And we're acting like we really don't know what we're doing. Hold on. Camera's still going. Where is it?
Hurry up, we're losing time.
Ladies and gentlemen, secret ingredient. Remember, this is going to be edited. You've seen it nowhere else but here.
A little cap of heat.
Yeah. Secret ingredient shit. I mean stuff.
Whoa!
That's right.
Of course you're gonna light anything with fuel.
Of course, but you got it, use it.
Alright, we're gonna see you in a few seconds. We're gonna take a little break. And I don't know. We're gonna do some cooking.